Welcome back to my Road to Completion Guide for Resident Evil 3 Remake. This is episode 4. Leave the makeshift sick room and read the file in the next room. Kill all the zombies and destroy the Charlie doll in the hallway.
I don't got time for this!
Pick up the tape player and read the file in the next room.
Please state your business clearly into the intercom.
Kill the zombies in the next room and follow me to the roof so we can destroy the next Charlie doll. Jump out of the window around the corner and pick up the tactical grip for the assault rifle, the locker room key, and the assault rifle ammo. Backtrack and make your way to the safe room where you'll find more ammo, a file, and a typewriter. There are two files in the next area, plus a flash grenade and a hospital ID card in the locker area. On your way out, grab the assault rifle ammo off the desk and equip the flash grenade. Exiting this room will trigger a cutscene followed by an encounter with the hunter. Use the flash grenade to stun the hunter and shoot him with the assault rifle until he dies. Make your way to the information desk and post up near the door behind the counter and kill the zombies. Once the zombies are cleared out, circle through the back room and pick up the assault rifle ammo, hand grenade, and shoot the Charlie doll in the trash can. Open the safe using the following combination: 9 left, 3 right. Pick up the dual magazine and combine it with the assault rifle. Discard the key and read the file. There's more assault rifle ammo in the next room. Just make sure to kill the two zombies first. Use the flash grenade followed by the hand grenade to kill both hunters in the next room. Be extremely careful because it's possible for the hunters to come inside the room you're currently in. If they do, back up into the hallway and wait for them to reset. You can slowly walk through the doorway and shoot them a few times before they rush you, then fall back into the hallway for safety. Keep repeating this until they're both dead. Just make sure to keep one flash grenade because we'll need it later. Now we can pick up the assault rifle ammo and the audio cassette tape. You can place the audio cassette tape inside the tape player. We'll need this for later. Backtrack to the information desk and switch to the flash grenade. As soon as you exit this room, get ready to throw the flash grenade to stun the hunter roaming the hallway, then take it out with the assault rifle. Follow me to the operating room so we can read a file, stock up on grenades, and replenish our ammo. Use the tape player to gain access to Bard's lab. There's more ammo on the left and a file we can read just behind his body.
All I wanted to know was what the documents were doing in your office in the first place.
Who do you think you're talking to? I'm goddamn Nathaniel Bard. I'm the best biologist you'll ever meet, you bet.
Bard. Tyrell, Bard's dead.
Pick up the assault rifle ammo before reading the email on the computer. After that, grab the vaccine sample and head back to the makeshift sick room to give it to Jill.
Is it here? All right, Jill. Hang tight.
T?
On the way, you'll have an encounter with the hunter, but you can use the flash grenade followed by the hand grenade to kill it.
Hey,
You're gonna be okay, Jill.
Discard all the items with the trash can icon to free up inventory space, and set up two manual saves, one for farming and one for a backup should one of the files become corrupted.
Grab some gear. Sounds like there's a lot of them out there.
Leave the sick room and pick up all the ammo in the next area so we can officially start the farming process. We can farm a minimum of 5 challenges for a total of 26,400 points.
Okay, now the fun shit begins.
Here are the challenges. Necessary Violence for defeating 400 enemies. Trusty Sidearm for defeating 80 enemies with a handgun. Suppressing Fire for defeating 200 enemies with an assault rifle. Spitting Lead for defeating 400 enemies with an assault rifle, and Making a Dent for defeating 800 enemies. So what's the strategy? Well, we want to kill as many enemies as we can before we run out of ammo for the shotgun and the assault rifle. The good thing about this farming spot is that more ammo for both guns will spawn later in the sequence. So obviously headshots will conserve our ammo, but if you have a ton of assault rifle bullets, it's okay to aim for the body instead. When it comes to the handgun, I would definitely go for headshots because you'll have less ammo for the handgun than the assault rifle. You will have to worry about two hunters during this sequence, but they are easily killed with the well-placed grenade. I'll show you where to get more grenades shortly after the lights go out. We can maximize this farming spot by killing the unlimited waves of zombies instead of detonating the bomb in the lobby. Exhaust all of your assault rifle and handgun ammo, then load your previous save and repeat. Some of you may unlock more challenges during this process, but it really depends on how often you've died and reloaded saves, but at a minimum, we need to complete the challenges I mentioned earlier. I will show the entire farming run up until I run out of ammo for both guns, and then I'll follow up with clips of me unlocking all 5 challenges. This will take some time, but the payoff is worth it, trust me.
Come on.
Find the breaker. It must be somewhere.
I'm on it.
Somehow. lock the door somehow.
When all the farming is done, detonate the bomb and you'll pick up another trophy.
Explodey way it is.
Carlos! Can you use that explosive to block the door somehow?
pick up the items in the room and set up a save before exploring the hospital with Jill. Follow me and I'll show you where to use the lockpick so we can get another trophy called Master of Unlocking. We will pick up the Lightning Hawk during this process, which will give us another trophy called Kendo's Armory for finding all the weapons in the campaign. There will be hunters roaming the hospital during this sequence, so keep the grenade launcher and the hand grenades equipped. Be sure to make room in your inventory for the mag ammo by combining or discarding handgun ammo.
I think I can squeeze by. Guaranteed to give you a headache.
On the way to the underground facility, shoot the Charlie doll standing on the forklift. You will find a hip pouch, a file, and a typewriter in the next safe room, and that will wrap up this episode. If you have any questions, let me know, and I'll see you in the next one. Be good.
No one in the hospital ever noticed all this.
If you enjoy my videos and would like to support my work, you can do so at Patreon. I offer a ton of rewards from behind the scenes coverage, RTC visual guides, and workbooks. Pledges start at $1 a month, and for those of you who support me already, I greatly appreciate it.